So in this video we will be seeing about the cookie tampering. Generally there will be some websites, like most of the websites today's, they will be adding this option, remember me while logging in. So what this does is it will keep you your account logged in for so many days, even for weeks or even for months. So if you take an example like Amazon account, if you logged in by this checking this remember me box or stay logged in, then a cookie will be assigned to you. So that cookie will be varied like for several days or even for months. Like after you 1 week, if you go to the Amazon, still you see your account being logged in and it will not ask you for login again. So that cookie will be generated using some random characters, or sometimes the timestamp or even the password or username of the user is included. So the username or password should not be related to the cookies, because attacker can create an account and he can just decode the cookie and decides how the cookie has been formed with the username or password. So in this setup we will be seeing that, and with the help of decoding the cookie, and we will brute force the user Carlos. So this is the login page and winner Peter. So click on this stay logged in and click on login. So now you can see the session value, click on forward this, and we have successfully logged in as winner. Now if you go to cookies and you get one more cookie, that is stay logged in. So copy this one. So we don't know what this is, so let's try to just decode this in base64. So you can see we got the winner colon hash value. So what you can do is you can hash ID. So it says mostly like MD5 hash. So let's, what we need to do is MD5 hash. So we know the password for the winner, that is Peter. So if you generate the MD5 hash for this, and you can see 51DC, and it's the same for the password. So that means the stay logged in cookie has been generated by using the username colon password hash of that user, and it's in a base64 encoded format. So now we can, let's write a simple Python script for this. So we'll be dealing with the base64 encoding and decoding, and also MD5 hashing. So let's just say this is the, sorry, this is the cookie. So it's in the format username colon let's say base64 of username colon MD5 of password. So I have already they have given the password verist here. You can download this one. This is the same as the previous labs. So I can just simply copy this one to get the all passwords in the list file. So we got the all the passwords. Okay. Now for I in passwords. Now what you need to do is, so first we need to generate the cookie, right? So let's refresh this page and copy all this. So we need to brute force. Which one? This one. Stay logged in is dot format of I. So we are generating the headers and we are going to send this one request.get of URL comma headers is equals to headers. So before that we need to generate the I, or we can say, let's say hash value is equals to, so the format is username colon md5 of password. So hash rip dot md5 of I dot encode dot hexadigest. So if you print this one you will get the exact hash, and what you need to do is we need to append this to carlos, because the carlos is the user, right? Carlos colon hash value. So you will get the hash value of this one, and you need to base64 encode this one. Base64.b64 encode of hash value dot decode. So you get the raw bytes if you encode this one. So you need to decode this to get the exact hash value. So you can just say hash value. So let's capture the request and send this to repeater, and here let's change this cookie value to something wrong and we see the response. So instead of w let's say 1. So we need to filter according to the responses. So let's print r.text. I think we will get a lot more values. We're getting so many results, and let's first print this hash values. So we are generating the hash values correctly. So we need to filter these responses. So if the Carlos account has been logged in, it will say your username is Carlos, right? So I think we could filter according to that. And we are printing the password and we are breaking the loop. So I don't think we get the response like. So we are getting the same response, right? Your username is Wiener. So I don't think we get the your username is Carlos, or we can get the redirect. And also there is a this thing, update email. So this is also getting in every wrong response. So let's try that. So we did not get any results. So let's try update email. So let's say update email not in. So let's change this cookie at all. So let's say cookies. So let's try this one. Okay, cookies is equals to cookies. So the session cookie and stay logged in cookie. So we did not get any passwords. So I think I have found our error. So let's remove this session cookie. So because of session cookie, we are getting the same response irrespective of this stay logged in cookie. Now send this. Send with stay logged in. So we are getting redirected to the login page. So that means you need to remove the session cookie. So it's identifying the session cookie and it is verifying you, like it's giving the common response. So now you can see we got the password. So all I did this removing this session value parameter in the cookies value. So this took very much time. So we can log out this and click on my account and Carlos and paste the password, stay logged in, and we have successfully logged in as Carlos. So sorry for the long time. So this session, the response was the same because of the session cookie. So we need to remove that and brute force this only the stay logged in parameter.